أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Praise be to Allah who created out of nothing the heavens and the earth, who made the angels messengers with wings, two or three or four pairs. He adds to creation as He pleases, for Allah has power over all things. What Allah out of His mercy does bestow on mankind, there is none who can withhold. What He does withhold, there is none who can grant, apart from Him, and He is the exalted in power, full of wisdom. O men, call to mind the grace of Allah unto you. Is there a creator other than Allah to give you sustenance from heaven or earth? There is no God but He. How then are you deluded away from the truth? And if they reject you, so were messengers rejected before you. To Allah go back for decision all affairs. O men, certainly, the promise of Allah is true. Let not then this present life deceive you, nor let the chief deceiver deceive you about Allah. Verily, Satan is an enemy to you, so treat him as an enemy. He only invites his adherents, that they may become companions of the blazing fire. For those who reject Allah is a terrible penalty, but for those who believe and work righteous deeds is forgiveness and a magnificent reward. Is he then to whom the evil of his conduct is made alluring, so that he looks upon it as good, equal to one who is rightly guided? For Allah leaves to stray whom He wills and guides whom He wills, so let not your soul go out in vainly sighing after them. For Allah knows well all that they do. It is Allah who sends forth the winds, so that they raise up the clouds, and we drive them to a land that is dead, and revive the earth therewith after its death. Even so will be the resurrection. If any do seek for glory and power, to Allah belong all glory and power. To Him mount up all words of purity. It is He who exalts each deed of righteousness. Those that lay plots of evil, for them is a penalty terrible, and the plotting of such will be void of result. And Allah did create you from dust, then from a sperm drop, then He made you in pairs, and no female conceives or lays down her load but with His knowledge. Nor is a man long-lived granted length of days, nor is a part cut off from his life, but is in a decree ordained. All this is easy for Allah. Nor are the two bodies of flowing water alike, the one palatable, sweet, and pleasant to drink, and the other, salty and bitter. Yet from each kind of water do you eat flesh fresh and tender, and you extract ornaments to wear, and you see the ships therein that plough the waves, that you may seek thus of the bounty of Allah, that you may be grateful. He merges night into day, and He merges day into night, and He has subjected the sun and the moon to His law. Each one runs its course for a term appointed. Such is Allah your Lord. To Him belongs all dominion, and those whom you invoke besides Him have not the least power. If you invoke them, they will not listen to your call, and if they were to listen, they cannot answer your prayer. On the day of judgment, they will reject your partnership. And none, O man, can tell you the truth like the one who is acquainted with all things. O you man, it is you that have need of Allah, but Allah is the one free of all wants, worthy of all praise. If He so pleased, He could blot you out and bring in a new creation. Nor is that at all difficult for Allah. Nor can a bearer of burdens bear another's burden, if one heavily laden should call to another to bear his load. Not the least portion of it can be carried by the other, even though he be nearly related. You can but admonish such as fear their Lord unseen and establish regular prayer. And whoever purifies himself does so for the benefit of his own soul, and the destination of all is to Allah. The blind and the seeing are not alike. Nor are the depths of darkness and the light. Nor are the chilly shade and the genial heat of the sun. Nor are alike those that are living and those that are dead. Allah can make any that He wills to hear, but you cannot make those to hear who are buried in graves. You are no other than a warner. Verily, we have sent you in truth, as a bearer of glad tidings and as a warner. And there never was a people without a warner having lived among them in the past. And if they reject you, so did their predecessors, to whom came their messengers with clear signs, scriptures, and the book of enlightenment. In the end did I punish those who rejected faith, and how terrible was my rejection of them. See you not that Allah sends down rain from the sky? With it we then bring out produce of various colors. And in the mountains are tracts white and red, of various shades of color, and black intense in hue. And so amongst men and crawling creatures and cattle are they of various colors, those truly fear Allah, among His servants who have knowledge, for Allah is exalted in might, oft forgiving. Those who rehearse the book of Allah, establish regular prayer, and spend in charity out of what we have provided for them, secretly and openly, hope for a commerce that will never fail. For He will pay them their meed, nay, He will give them even more out of His bounty, for He is oft forgiving, most ready to appreciate service. That which we have revealed to you of the book is the truth, confirming what was revealed before it. For Allah is assuredly, with respect to His servants, well acquainted and fully observant. Then we have given the book for inheritance to such of our servants as we have chosen. But there are among them some who wrong their own souls, some who follow a middle course, and some who are, by Allah's leave, foremost in good deeds. That is the highest grace. Gardens of eternity will they enter. Therein will they be adorned with bracelets of gold and pearls, and their garments there will be of silk. And they will say, Praise be to Allah who has removed from us all sorrow. For our Lord is indeed oft forgiving, ready to appreciate service. Who has out of His bounty settled us in a home that will last? No toil nor sense of weariness shall touch us therein. But those who reject Allah, for them will be the fire of hell. No term shall be determined for them, so they should die. Nor shall its penalty be lightened for them. Thus do we reward every ungrateful one. Therein will they cry aloud for assistance. Our Lord, bring us out. We shall work righteousness, not the deeds we used to do. Did we not give you long enough life, so that he that would should receive admonition? And moreover, the warner came to you, so taste you the fruits of your deeds. For the wrongdoers, there is no helper. Verily, Allah knows all the hidden things of the heavens and the earth. Verily, He has full knowledge of all that is in men's hearts. He it is that has made you inheritors in the earth. If then any do reject Allah, their rejection works against themselves. Their rejection but adds to the odium for the unbelievers in the sight of their Lord. Their rejection but adds to their own undoing. Say, have you seen these partners of yours whom you call upon besides Allah? Show me what it is they have created in the wide earth, or have they a share in the heavens? Or have we given them a book from which they can derive clear evidence? Nay, the wrongdoers promise each other nothing but delusions. It is Allah who sustains the heavens and the earth, lest they cease to function. And if they should fail, there is none, not one, can sustain them thereafter. Verily, He is most forbearing, oft forgiving. They swore their strongest oaths by Allah, that if a warner came to them, they would follow his guidance better than any other of the peoples. But when a warner came to them, it has only increased their flight from righteousness. On account of their arrogance in the land and their plotting of evil, but the plotting of evil will hem in only the authors thereof. Now are they but looking for the way the ancients were dealt with. But no change will you find in Allah's way of dealing, no turning off will you find in Allah's way of dealing. Do they not travel through the earth and see what was the end of those before them, though they were superior to them in strength? Nor is Allah to be frustrated by anything whatever in the heavens or on earth, for He is all-knowing, all-powerful. If Allah were to punish men according to what they deserve, He would not leave on the back of the earth a single living creature, but He gives them respite for a stated term. When their term expires, verily, Allah has in His sight all His servants.